गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ कितांगी शर्मा, योर एसएसटी टीचर। इफ यू रिमेंबर चिल्ड्रन, यस्टरडे वी हैव कवर्ड द टॉपिक सीजन्स ऑफ द ईयर एंड टुडे वी शैल लर्न अबाउट डे एंड नाइट। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ रिकैप। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, what are the five seasons of the year? Spring, summer, winter, autumn, rainy are five seasons of the year. Okay students, and what changes the direction of the winds? Spinning of the earth changes the direction of the winds. In which months neither of tropics receive direct sunlight? In the month of March and September, neither of tropics receive direct sunlight. When does winter begins? Winter begins on 22nd December. And when does autumn begin? Autumn begins on 23rd September. And when does spring season begin? Spring season begins on 21st March. So these are some questions which were already discussed. Now let's read the chapter. Start from here. Thus, there are five main seasons. It is to be remembered that changes of seasons are experienced away from the equator. It means when do we experience the changes of season? It can be possible only away from the equator. The changes of seasons are experienced away from the equator only. The equatorial regions remain hot throughout the year without experiencing any change of seasons. Equatorial regions means near the equator. So the regions near the equator remain hot throughout the year, okay, which means there is no changes of seasons. Equatorial regions have the same season, same means hot throughout the year without experiencing any change of seasons. Okay students, once again I'm repeating, changes of seasons can be experienced only away from the equator, not near the equator, away from the equator. Now come to the next topic, day and night. Day and night is the result of the rotation of the earth on its axis. Are you getting children? What causes day and night? It is the result of the rotation of the earth on its axis. And what is rotation? Movement of the earth on its axis. Okay, apni hi jagah par ghumna earth ka. That is called rotation. So due to the rotation of the earth, we have day and night. The axis of the earth is an imaginary line that passes through the north and the south pole. Axis of the earth is an imaginary line. It is an imaginary line, not in real, which passes through the north and the south pole. North pole means 90 degree north and south pole means 90 degree south. The earth takes approximately 24 hours to complete one rotation. Approximately means roughly our earth takes 24 hours to complete one rotation. Okay, the sun is the source of light. What is the source of light? Sun is the source of light. At the same time of the rotation, means during the rotation, it is day on the side of the earth that faces the sun, while it is night on the other side of the earth not facing the sun. It means the side which faces to the sun has day, and the side which is opposite to the sun, it has night. Okay, student? Once again I am repeating. The side which faces the sun has day, and the sun and the side which do not faces the sun, which means which is opposite to the sun, not having the day, it has night. The position of the sun is fixed and it does not change, which means sun does not move. Sun nahi hilta apni jagah se. It is fixed. It does not change. Who moves? Earth moves. Okay, there is a movement of the earth, not the movement of the sun. Student, this is the diagram of day and night. It is very clear from the diagram. The side which faces the sun has day, and the side which is opposite to the sun has night. Okay, students. The length of the day and night varies in each season. Varies means different. So day and night are different in different season. For example, the daylight is longer in summer and the night is shorter. During summer season, daylight is longer and the night is shorter. And in winter, the nights are longer and the days are short. So, which means we have different length of day and night in different seasons. It is the length of the day and night that determine the temperature of the seasons, and not the revolution of the earth. How can we determine the temperature of the seasons? With the help of the length of the day and night. Okay? Not the revolution of the earth. So, our chapter has completed. Now, note down the homework. Students, it's your homework. Read chapter 3 and do book exercise in book only. Read chapter 3 and do book exercise in book. So, you need to read the chapter very carefully, then you can fill the book exercise. Okay, students? Now, we will meet in our next tutorial. Till then, goodbye.